up, master? Sitting here trying to get on my nigga bands. Niggas get the misconception of us. Cause we're so cold and hungry, dude. But I really want to let niggas know what's happening.
I think I'm too old to know what that song is. Like, alright, where's my Kansas City, Kansas people? Where were they? You guys in the front? Yeah. Kansas City, Missouri. It's a real thing. You guys don't exist. There we go. Yeah, Kansas City, Missouri. We get the Chiefs. You get the soccer team and the raceway. I lived in McPherson, Kansas for years, so I'm just excited. I did just recently retire from the Navy about, two and a half months ago. This has always kind of been a dream of mine, not Monkey Island specifically, but to do comedy. It was also, I retired and I got a beard. She's right over there.
Woo!
No, my wife hates my beard. She actually told me that the other day. It was very hard. I haven't been able to grow one for 21 years. As you can see, I can. Right. And she said, I don't like it. And I said, what's your problem with it? She says, I don't like to move all the hair out of the way to get to your lips. And I said, well, now we're on common ground. She hates that joke. One of the things I've had to learn to kind of do is take a more active role in being a father. We have a 12-year-old girl. I've always been able to kind of default to being at work. Obviously now unemployed, I am the guy answering all the questions. So we get a lot of time in the car back and forth from work. And I don't know, who has kids in here? Like, do you have school-age kids, anybody? Ooh, you know what they're learning in school? So, well, this isn't going to go how you think. Oklahoma just banned a bunch of books, right? Like everybody saw that in the news, right? We're controlling what people are learning. That's
right.
The purpose of the government, right? We can do stuff like that. And my daughter says, Dad, do you know that in order for a body to sink, you have to puncture their lungs? I said, I'm Italian. Of course I know. Where did you hear that? And she said, it's in school. Did you also know that, the first form of biological warfare was they would disease a body, they would infect it with diseases and let the body bloat, and then they would throw it over a wall. I said, I'm so much more comfortable with The Kill a Mockingbird than I am my daughter learning to be a sociopath. There are so many worse things than understanding equality at age 12. Can we agree on that?
Yes.
Holy cow, critical race theory has nothing on the Mongolians, okay? One of the great joys I have, I was raised by women, my dad was pretty non-existent. And I'm raising a girl, so it's all girls in my life, right? My whole life has been all girls. She's 12, she's great. And being a girl dad is interesting, right? It's supposed to be this thing like Kobe Bryant, when she's an athlete, she does all that. My daughter, none of that. We have nothing that we do alike. She's a lot like I was when I was a kid, though. She likes a lot of the same kind of things. And so, one of the things that we went to this restaurant and they had unisex bathrooms. You guys been to a place like this? Yeah, weird. Okay, I'm sorry, for me it's weird. It's not weird for her. For her, at first she was like, oh, cool. All right, I'll go in, I'll lock the door. She came out almost immediately. And I said, what are you doing? I said, did you use the bathroom? She said, Dad, there's poop behind the toilet. I said, there's poop where? She was behind the toilet. I said, oh. She was, you're not worried about it? I said, hey, welcome to the men's room. Right? We've known for years that we're animals. Right? This is not a surprise to me. I wish I could use just the women's bathroom. I'm sure it's better than ours. But she was very bothered by it. I said, your grandmother burned her bras for the right for you to go to this bathroom with the poop behind the toilet. You're lucky there wasn't pee on the ceiling. I've been in those. You can't get out dry. I don't know what to tell you. One of the more interesting conversations we had recently, she recently is becoming a lady, and she had summertime softball practice. And as a dad, I can tell you, I'm woefully unprepared for this. Like, the parenting classes that you get early on cover from, like, birth to six. and the rest of it you're on your own. Right? There's so much more that happens after six. And so she says, Dad, you know, I've got really bad cramps. I can't go to practice today. I say, hey, I have it on good accord. Working out helps with cramps. And I don't know if this is true, but that's what my mom and sister told me. And so she goes to softball practice, has this great practice. And I say, hey, I'm so proud of you. Right? You really toughed it out. You did a great job today at practice. And she goes, Dad, I was having period pains. So I was like, I get it. So in typical dad fashion, I say, well, at least they weren't exclamation mark pains, right? And she's normally not entertained by me anyway, but given the timing, she was really not. She said, Dad, I'm bleeding from my vagina. And I said, oh, God, you're disgusting. Don't ever say that to me again. And she said, what would you do? I said, I don't have one. And she goes, no, if I cut you on the arm right now and you started bleeding, what would you do? This is in the car. I'm not making any of this up, by the way. Real conversation. I looked at her and said, what would I do? She goes, yeah, I said, I'm field medical certified. I would apply pressure. I would put a tourniquet on and go to the doctor. What I wouldn't do is let it go for a week. Pretend everything's fine for the next 3 weeks and then let it all happen again. So I'll leave you with this one. Because that conversation didn't go so well, we're going to Target. I was going to buy her some stuff and we needed to get some feminine products anyway. So we're in those aisles, and I don't know if you all know this. This is very true. They sell sex toys at Target. Yes, don't be Googling where the next Target is. Wait till I'm off stage. It's true. Listen to me. I'm walking through the aisle looking for feminine products, and my daughter walks up and puts something in the cart. And I said, what is that? She goes, you tell me. I said, I don't know where you found that. And she goes, over here. I'm like, oh my God. So she goes, what is this? I said, well, I have a really simple answer for the question you had earlier about Roe v. Wade. She says, what's that? I said, well, come with me. We walked over to where the condoms were. I said, you see how these are locked up? She goes, yeah. I said, okay. If you could access those, that would help you from getting pregnant, right? She goes, yeah. So, but the state of Oklahoma, we're not that concerned with it. She's right. I said, okay. So they lock that up. We're not going to help you. But on aisle 7, you can go fuck yourself. I'm Casey Montino. Thank you all very much.